So let's talk about some of those high-tech tools, both that we have and that we'd like to see in the classroom, and how they might contribute to the goals of creating that kind of a learner.
Well, let me start with a school system in the eastern part of the state. Okay. A school district in the eastern part of the state, through a grant, has purchased smartphones or cell phones for students who initially struggled in mathematics. And what we've seen after 3 years of smartphones being used in mathematics classes is that students who have those smartphones have developed a love for math. The other thing that we have learned is the students with the smartphones are scoring at much higher levels on our end of course tests in algebra than students who do not have smartphones. The other thing that we have learned is that these students who have the smartphones and who can communicate with each other are really developing a learning community. They're helping each other learn mathematics. And they're also seeing how mathematics is really used in the world around them. Wow. So that's one excellent example of how technology is really advancing learning.
And that might come as a surprise to some folks. We did get an email from Durham. And let's talk about sort of the other side of this, okay, of this issue. Durham says, I'm a substitute teacher in Durham, North Carolina. I was wondering what your feelings were on the allowance of cell phones, Palm Pilots, and other handheld technology in the classroom. I know they can be useful in the delivery of knowledge, but where do you draw the line when these items become a distraction or disrupt the classroom? So what's your opinion on this issue? Now we've gotten a good sense of the good side. How does one make that distinction?
Well, first of all, we as educators, with the help of the students, must figure out how all these devices can be used as instructional tools rather than instructional distractions. We must teach our students etiquette as it relates to the use of cell phones. We must help them know how they can use these in productive ways. For example, when I was in school, we were given a calendar and we were asked to record our homework assignments, what we should do every day. Well, in this day and time, our students can record that type of information using the calendar on a cell phone. So there are many ways that we really can advance student learning by using PDAs, cell phones, smartphones, computers in the classroom. And our young people, even though they're very savvy in using these tools, they need the guidance of adults in how you use the information that you may get from these devices.
And really make the most out of those
right.
devices too. That I can imagine how that would motivate a student to find out that they can do so many more things than just maybe play solitaire.
Right.